All of you, welcome back to course of computing. Our today's topic of video is the application of adaptive neurofuzzy inference system, that is a printer character recognition. So here we are going to discuss one of the application of NFS, that is printer character recognition. So in this case I'm going to tell you in detail how printer character recognition works and what are the its application, where it can be used. Actually it's an application of NFS, but it can be used in a multiple domain. So where you can use this, I will tell you, and also I will tell you how it works actually. So first of all, we try to understand what is printer character recognition. So this printer character recognition is also known as optical character recognition. Actually this concept was very old, and it is not a case that this is a very new concept. It is a very old concept. Traditionally OCR is very famous. So I will tell you what is the use of OCR. So this is a small diagram which gives the idea of OCR. OCR stands for optical character recognition. That means we have to recognize a text which is present in the image. Suppose this is an image which I have given as an input to my model, and then my model should detect the text and recognize it. Here you can see Judas, Priest, 577, 587. These are the text which is written on that particular page. So that is being detected and recognized by our model. So OCR is a kind of technology which is used to read the text, or which is used to extract the text from an image. So this is what a OCR. So again we can say that it's an electronic translation of an image, handwritten images, typewritten or printed text into machine editable text, because the text which is present in the image is not editable, because you have captured the image. Suppose you want to perform some kind of operation on that particular text which is present in the image. So for that purpose, what you need to do, you need to extract the text from the image and place somewhere, and then you will perform the operation. So OCR is a kind of technology which help us to extract the text from the image. And why it is being used currently, so much used in the nowadays, because the increasing use of smartphone in our day-to-day life to capture the image initiate a need to extract the text from the image. Traditionally images means that much image is not captured, but nowadays smartphone is available, and that smartphone is capable of just taking the image very easily. Because a few years back, or you can say in the 2005, so at that time mostly we are using camera to capture the image. But nowadays we are having a smartphone, so very easily we are capturing the image with the help of smartphone. Means the thing is that that image data is increased as compared to the traditionally. Means before a few years ago, that much data is present, but that data is present in the form of text. But nowadays it is observed that most of the data is present in the image form. Why? Because in our day-to-day life we are capturing different images, and in that case some kind of text is present. So how to extract the text, make use of this text and use it for further application, for further processing, or in order to perform any kind of change. So for that purpose this OCR is very important. So printer character recognition is also known as optical character recognition. That means it's a process of extracting the text from the image and storing it in a particular place and converting into machine editable form. Actually OCR is one of the field of research in case of pattern recognition AI, and mostly in the field of computer vision. See, nowadays OCR is replaced by text detection and recognition. Nowadays text detection and recognition is a extended version of OCR. Means, see, traditionally OCR is, see, OCR only works with the handwritten data, printer character data, means particular document. Suppose we have particular document, just like a book, textbook is there, particular note is written. So if you want to read that, so we, for that purpose you can use OCR. But nowadays seen images are very much in use. So for that purpose OCR is not that much useful. So that is being replaced by text detection and recognition. So nowadays mostly text detection and recognition is used to extract the text from the image. But still we need to discuss about the OCR, because it's a traditional technology. A lot of advancement has been done in that OCR technology. So it is one of the application in the computer vision field. Computer vision means what? We are providing the ability to the computer to capture the image, okay, to capture the image, to visualize the image. So this is one of the hot research topic in the field of computer vision. So let's try to understand how exactly the OCR works. So here I have shown you this diagram through which I will try to explain how that OCR will work. Suppose this is an input image. For example, this is a particular bill. Suppose we go to the that particular shop, supermarket, we purchase a product and that bill is generated. So in that case, what I need to do, I need to extract the text which is present in that bill and make I need to store it in an Excel file. So how can I do this? Suppose I provide this input image, then image processing will done. So why do we require image processing? So what exactly we are doing? Actually, most of the time the images which we have captured are not in an appropriate format. Means noisy images there, blur images is there. So by using that image processing, we try to improve the quality of the image so that very easily we can extract the text from the image and provide it to the user. So image processing involves various operations, including noise removal, removal of particular noisy data, unnecessarily data. Okay, so that process we are doing because nowadays it can be used in the machine learning and deep learning. So first of all, you need to train your model, and in order to train your model, you need to provide the data set in an appropriate format. You have to normalize it, you have to make this all the images of the same size, same dimension. You need to provide it to the model, and for that purpose maybe you are going to use the annotation tool. For example, LabelIMG is one of the image annotation tool that can be used to annotate the text which is present in the image, because we have been provided with a n number of images. So initially what we need to do, we need to teach our model how to detect the text from the image. So for that purpose we have the image, so we need to detect, we need to localize the text which is present in the image, and then we'll try to train our model that this is a text which is present in the image, so that our model will understand that this is a part where text is being present, because text is coming with not in only in a simple format. Traditionally OCR is used for scan documents, it is used for scanning the book. So in case of book, what you observe that the text is present in a uniform format, okay, text is present in a uniform format, specific font size is used. But in case of a scene images, the font size, the lighting condition is very different. So that's why nowadays OCR is very challenging, which is easier, which is easy in the earlier days, but now is very difficult. So for that purpose, you required a image processing. After image processing, then there will be a text detection. Text detection means what? It's a process of localizing a text which is present in the image. Where exactly that text is present? So we need to localize the text. After localizing the text, we need to recognize it, what exactly it is written. Suppose text detection will localize the text which is present in that particular image, then we have to recognize it, what exactly that particular text, then restructuring it, and you need to provide the output. So from this input image we can able to extract the text. So it involves various phases: pre-processing of the image, text localization, segmentation, recognition, and post-processing. In order to improve the accuracy of that particular text, we need to take some apply some techniques over there. So it involves in the process of post-processing. So in this way optical character recognition works. OCR mainly involves two things. One is a detection, text detection, and text recognition. These are the two important phases in the OCR. So I hope you understand how OCR exactly works. Now the next thing is, what are the different benefits of OCR? So benefit is that transfer paper document to electronic form. It helps us to transfer the paper document to electronic form. That means my data is present in the image form, so I can transfer it to me. Suppose I have one document, okay, I have some document in the hard copy, and I need to convert it into digital form. So what I need to do, I need to take just image, I just capture the image and then try to extract the text from that particular image so that I will get the data in electronic form. So it accelerates the data processing, because suppose I need to process the data which is present in the hard copy, how can I process it? So for that purpose I can use OCR to extract the text from the document, from the image, and then use it. Faster retrieval of the information, then no space is required for document storage, because generally keeping the document physically in a particular go down, particular room, it's a time taking process. It takes a lot of space, because if you go to a particular go down of particular institution, you may find n number of documents are there. So instead of this, suppose we need to just reduce the space required, so what we need to do, we need to scan all the documents, extract the text and store it in a computer. So we can store huge amount of data in terms of GB, TB and so on. So in that sense we are saying that OCR helps to reduce the space required to keep your document, and it also increase the reliability of information present in the document, because there can be any natural calamity. Suddenly there is a fire burst, okay, suddenly there is a fire in that particular office, so what will happen, all documents get busted, okay, so all documents get gutted. So in that case, how to increase the reliability of a document, you just scan the document, store it in a somewhere else and extract the image. So OCR help us to increase the reliability of information also. And mostly in that OCR field, Tesseract is one of the open source library provided by Google for this particular work of optical character recognition. So how this work, it takes image acquisition, then it localizes the image, pre-process it, extract the feature, because it involves deep learning. In case of deep learning, we have to use neural network architecture. So we may use CNN or variations of that CNN to extract the features from the image. Then we have to recognize the text and store it in a document. So nowadays we can say Tesseract is one of the open source library provided by Google which can be used for optical character recognition. The next one is, what are the different applications of OCR? Where exactly OCR will be used? So OCR can be used to read the passport, invoice, bank statement and receipt. In case of a bank, in order to just read the text from the image which is present, so there you can use it for clearing the checks. Means we want that machine should just read the text which is present in the image, read the text, extract it and store it. So there you can use it. Then automatic number plate recognition system. So suppose you are just traveling on the road, so that camera has to capture the image and it has to detect and recognize the number written on your number plate. So number plate recognition is one of the application of OCR. Then in case of airport, for passport recognition, we are using robots, we are using machine to visualize the information, to retrieve the text from the image. So for that purpose OCR can be used. Then automatic insurance document, means wherever in most of the institution they want that the information should not be present in the hard copy, but they want to store their information in the digital form. So there you can use to automate the work. We can use it extracting the business card information. Generally we have business card information, means suppose you are a business person, so how many visiting card you can keep. Instead of this, what you will do, just extract the text present from that business card and store it in your computer, or you can say in your mobile phone itself, so that instead of keeping that visiting card, you can throw it. So also extracting the business card information is also one of the application of OCR. Then more quickly make a textual version of printed document, just like a book scanning. Google Books is there, so Google is providing that technology. Google Books will be there, so printed documents will be there. So these are the application. So we can say these are the traditional applications of OCR. But nowadays I told you that the applications of this OCR there is a huge innovation in the field of OCR, and just because of this text detection and recognition, which is a part of a computer vision research. So robot vision, robot has to visualize the thing. Robot is traveling on the road, robot is traveling to pass the delivery. So robot has to visualize the text which is written on that particular board and act accordingly, extract the text. So for robot vision, text detection and recognition, which is advanced version of OCR, can be used. Then then you can use it for self-driving cars. The car is driving on the road, so on the beside sides of the road, n number of boards are there, speed limit is written there, some instruction is being written. So self-driving car means what? It's also a robot, it's a machine. So and I told you that computer vision is that field which is giving the ability to the machine to visualize just like a human being. We are visualizing with the help of our eye. So computer vision is one of the branch of a computer science which gives the ability to machine to visualize the object, to visualize the text. So similarly, self-driving car is traveling on the road, has to detect various symbols, text written below that symbol, has to detect it, recognize it, and according to that it has to take the decision. Then this is a latest application of text detection and recognition, advanced version of OCR, that is visual question answering. Suppose I have shown you the image, and in that case I am asking you what percentage of woman is suffering from diabetes in Australia. So you can easily say that 3.6%. So how you can see? By means of your eyes, you are just extracted the text from the image and then you are given the answer. But same thing, suppose I ask that particular robot that what is a percentage of woman that is suffering from diabetes in the Australia. So the answer is 3.6. So you and me can very easily visualize this thing, extract the text and give the answer. But what about robot? Robot has to detect the text, extract the text and then provide you as an answer, and that relevant. So visual question answering is again one of the latest application of this OCR field. And again, your image annotation and retrieval, this is again another latest application of this OCR. So I hope you understand what is the concept of OCR, that is optical character recognition. That is nothing but simply just extracting the text from the image and make use of it and store it in a machine readable form. So this is what OCR. So here we understand what is OCR, how OCR will work, which is open source library that we can use, what are its applications, and what are the advanced applications. Thank you.